The executive producer, Tommy, that's why.
Well, look who finally decided to grace us with his presence.
Nice to see you too, Pop.
What's your excuse this time?
Listen, you know I wanted to be here for this funeral. My flight got delayed.
Never crossed your mind to come here a day early?
Jesus, Dad, what difference would it have made? All right, listen. I know it's been a while since I've been around, but ever since we moved the TV network to China, it's been all on me.
So, your mother didn't need you? I didn't need you? Maybe you're right. What difference would it have made? Oh. One drink for your mother.
And when did you start drinking again?
Some things worse than bad habits, Tony. Much worse.
Yeah, I can see that. One drink. That's it. All right, so how's everything been? How's work?
What work?
The TV show that you're working on, Two Lives to Live?
That was canceled 2 years ago. Networks, they want young, fresh talent. They got no time for an old washed-up screenwriter. And then just a couple of months before the cancellation, your mother's cancer came back. And I tell you what, I don't want to talk about this right now. I'm going to bed.
So I guess I'll just let myself out then. Hey, Lisa, listen, I need a few more days here. So do me a favor, call Robert Walsh. Tell him I think I found that writer he's looking for. I'll have him script in a couple of days. I told you to stay by your phone.
Brought breakfast.
I'm not hungry.
You gotta eat something.
Just leave it on the table.
past due. Account sense of collections. Final notice.
Hey, give me that.
You know, you need help with money. I'm here for you.
Right. Your money would have made everything better, right?
You could have said something, that's all.
Well, you know, I guess the phone system in China was out of order because I could never get a hold of you. And I finally figured, well, we just don't mean anything to you anymore. So I stopped trying to bother you.
Just because I'm busy, it doesn't mean that I don't care about you.
See what I mean? Go ahead, take it. It's probably a lot more important than any of this.
So, Dad, that was Robert. What are you doing?
What does it look like I'm doing?
Jesus, I know I should have taken this bottle last night. You have a heart condition, for Christ's sake. What do you think this is going to make everything go away?
You have no idea what all this did to me. How hard it was on me. How do you think I made all those payments? All those medical procedures? Yeah. I don't expect anything anymore. All those nights at the hospital with your mother, and all she talked about was you. This is all I have left.
I screwed up. And I'm sorry that I've been... I'm sorry. It was Robert Walsh on the phone. He's one of the head writers at the studio. Mm-hmm. And, he loves your work. He wants to read one of your screenplays. What do you think?
What screenplay? I don't have a script. Why'd you do that, Tony? I haven't written anything good in 2 years.
You're David Concord, Dad. I mean, you've done this for decades. You're a genius to me and in the industry.
I don't know. I don't have a passion for writing anymore.
That's not true. And besides, I'm here to help. Like old times.
We could take it one day at a time. Thank you. Hey, you tired? Take my room. I'll finish this.
You sure it's kind of late?
Oh, yeah, I'm sure. Besides, I'm on a roll.
I gotta say, it's nice being here, Dad.
I'm just glad you finally made it back, Tony. Good night, son.
Good night, Dad. Dad, this is great. Hey, Pops. Hey, Pops. Hey, Dad.
If I knew that was the last time I would see my dad, I would have told him how much I love him. My life revolved around finding and opening the new doors for my new career. At the same time, I was forgetting about the ones who guided me along the way. So I decided to instate a new employee vacation policy at the TV network, allowing them paid vacation and family visitations. His heart gave out that night. I can't help the guilt for allowing this to happen. I didn't realize how much pain that I caused him. He was always trying to teach me a lesson about life in his own distinct way. I'm gonna miss that old man.